Okay, last lecture. This is kind of post-exploitation part two, because maneuver involves a lot of post-exploitation. Maneuver is where we try to take our current access and get more access. What I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to set up Metasploit's pivoting, which allows you to route traffic to a certain set of destinations through one compromised host. I'm going to show you how to scan through a pivot, and I'm going to show you how to attack hosts and abuse trust relationships through a pivot. Here's where we're at in the network attack process. We started out, remember we were in post-exploitation. Well, what we're going to do is we're going to grab credentials from a compromised host. We're going to set up pivoting. We're going to scan host through a pivot, and we're going to use those credentials to develop more access. And the process will repeat again. Again, this is going to be a demo-driven lecture, so let's get right to it. Oops, don't need that one. Let's go over here to backtrack 5. Here we are, backtrack 5 with a compromised Windows host. Always a compromised Windows host. First thing, you remember before we were doing post-exploitation. And I mentioned if you right-click, go to Meterpreter, access, you can see there's nifty dump hashes. What this will do is when you log into a Windows host, your password is stored in a hashed form. And it's stored in a database called the SAM database. And if you click dump hashes, Armitage will go ahead and grab those for you and store them in Metasploit's credentials database. And here it's saying, hey, your hashes have been dumped. Go to view credentials to see them. So let's go ahead and do that now. View credentials. And that's cool. We've got a few usernames and passwords, or usernames, and hashed passwords. Okay, no big deal. One thing you can do, and you should try, but probably won't do anything for you, is if you click crack passwords, Armitage will actually launch John the Ripper in the background and using its fast crack mode, and it'll try to crack those hashes. Now, most likely, nothing's going to come out of this, but why not? Try it out. So now that we've grabbed credentials, let's see what other hosts are available to us to hack into. First off, we want to do a scan. There's no point in doing a scan or setting up a pivot if there's nothing to scan. So what we're going to do is we're going to do an ARP scan. And you can do an ARP scan through Meterpreter without setting up a pivot. Just right-click the host, the compromised host, go to Meterpreter, ARP scan, and Armitage will bring up all the different networks that host has access to. So go ahead and just select one of them. In this case, I don't have access to 172.16.4.8, so I assume there's probably something interesting there. So let's go ahead and scan it. And an ARP scan is just a discovery scan. It just tells you which hosts are alive. Nothing else to it. And as you can see, hosts are starting to appear for us. But if we highlight those hosts, when we right-click and go to services, you can see Armitage doesn't know anything about it because we haven't done a port scan yet. So let's go ahead and set up a pivot so we can scan them. So I'm going to right-click, Meterpreter, pivoting, setup. And here Armitage gives me a list of hosts that I've got access to again, or networks. I'm going to click add pivot for the 172 network. And now all traffic originating from Metasploit, destined for any of these hosts, will go through this 192.168.95.166 host. And you can see it gave me this nifty message route added. So I'm going to click OK. One thing in Metasploit is pivoting works like a router. If I type route print, you can see I've got my, my network, my net mask to define how many hosts, and the gateway as the session. And Armitage visualizes this for you. If I click in the graph view and I press Control H, you can see here are all the hosts that I can pivot to through 192.168.95.166. Now the next thing I want to do is I want to scan these. Keep in mind, I don't know anything about them. So if I try to use Nmap, Nmap is a tool external to Metasploit, and it has no way of knowing that it should use a Metasploit pivot to go through and access these hosts, so it won't work. What I can do is I can right-click these hosts and go to scan. And this will launch 20 Metasploit modules whose purpose is to fingerprint the host and identify the common services. And you can already see, now that the module's been launched, we're starting to see which hosts are available to us. And if I click on the Services tab here, I can click Refresh, and it'll keep showing me all the different port scan information as we get it. And just give it a minute to run, more ports will come up. There we go. Immediately, you'll notice though, what we do have, we've got 172.168.171, which is a Linux box. We've got 48.3, which is Windows 2003 server of some sort, and 159, which is Windows XP Service Pack 2. Keep in mind, both these hosts are Windows XP Service Pack 2, so they may be the same host. So first thing, let's go ahead and abuse the trust relationship and use these credentials we've got. It looks like they may have cracked too. So if I go to refresh, yeah, you can see guest is blank and administrator is Tor, T-O-O-R. No big deal. All right, so this is a Windows 2003 Service Pack 0 host. An attack I'd like to try using these credentials is called pass the hash. On an Active Directory domain, when you log into a Windows host, as I mentioned, your password is hashed and stored in the SAM database. And when you try to connect to another host that's on the same Active Directory domain, Windows passes your username and the hash without asking you what your password is. So if your hash matches the one the other host has, or the one that the Active Directory domain believes is you, then you'll be able to log into the host. And if you have permission to create a new service and write a file, then you're able to get access to the host. And the way this works is through a module called psexec. So if I right click, go to login, psexec, this lets me, the Metasploit version of this lets me pass a hash. It'll work with the credential or with the hashed password. If I click launch, Metasploit will try through this pivot to log into that Windows host, upload Meterpreter, create that service, and if it works, I'll get lightning bolts on this 172.168.3 host. That's a pass the hash attack. And there you go. You can see the bright green line indicating that pivot's in use, and that, yep, we do indeed have access to this compromised host. So let me go ahead and make these a little bit smaller so you can see everything. Control minus and control plus will resize everything for you. So there you go, we've got access to another host. Got an interpreter session, and I can interact with the command shell, do all the nifty things I would normally do. Something else, I just typed netstat. You'll notice our connections between 172.168.3 and 172.168.159. Nowhere do you see a connection between me though, my attack computer in this host, because it's using the pivot. So that's a pass the hash attack, that's abusing a trust relationship. What about this Linux host? I could do the attacks, find attacks, and try to exploit it, but let's see if we can do anything else. I can right click, go to SSH, and here I'm presented with all the different usernames and passwords Armitage knows about. Now remember from our previous post-exploitation activity that we had those activity logs and we grabbed a file that had some passwords in it. If I go to view activity logs, July 19th was 192.166 downloads, passwords.txt. Here we've got this username and password, bad guy and evil things. Let's go ahead and try that one right now. Let's type bad guy. The password's evil things, and click launch. And using SSH, Armitage will try to log into that Linux host and get us code execution and give us session. And there we go. And you can see I've got all this ability to do post-exploitation in Linux host. And we haven't talked about it, but you do remember you can interact and type commands, ps netstat. And again, important to show you, the only established connection, 172.168.159 to this one. So these hosts, 159 and 166, must be the same host, different interfaces. You can also do post modules, get post module recommendations for a shell session. And you can see we've got Linux-specific post modules, and we've got the multi-ones. So something else that you can do. And you can also upload a file through a shell. That's something else Armitage gives you. So I point that out, just some cool post-exploitation stuff. That's the pass the hash and abusing credentials. So in a nutshell, it's a maneuver. I showed you how to set up a pivot, scan hosts through a pivot, abuse trust relationships through pass the hash to get access, and how to use existing credentials to get access. Now as a quick review, which module gives a session on a Windows host using credentials or hashes? PSExec. Which scan should you do before setting up a pivot? You should do an ARP scan that tells you if there are any hosts that are alive that may be interesting for you to look at. That's maneuver.